I'm Quay. I know Sim from early 2000s in college. First time I met her, she was this little thingy, and she walked up, and we're talking about the Lakers, and then immediately, best friends after that. So.
Sim is more like family to me. She's actually known her since Jamaica, before college days, and then she was my first roommate. First experience in college. That was a great time with Sim.
She was always welcoming and fun, and you know, we would go to the courts, you know, so she was just a great personality and a great person.
She's always not only a nice person, but always thinking of everybody else in her circle. And I love this girl, and it rocked my heart to know that she was at this stage in her life not here with us. But I really, really wish her, wherever she's at in heaven.
I met Simone at Kaplan as well, actually on the basketball court before that. Same thing, yeah. Basketball. They had like an after work. We get to get on Fridays and play basketball with coworkers. And Kent actually brought me out there for the first time, and we went and we played. And she told me, hey, make sure every week you come back. So continued from there. I didn't realize she worked with me at the time. Then found out we all worked together, and then you know, started hanging out. We would go every now and then. We'd go to lunch, hang out. After that, actually, you know, kept in touch from time to time. Like, very gentle spirit. Probably one of the most genuine people I've ever met in my life. And that's a lot to say, because I mean, you come across a lot of people every day, but not that many people actually put that kind of foothold on you, to where anywhere you see them, it's like you just saw them last week, no matter how much time passed. And she's one of the great ones, man. Like, one of the people that I've seen, I don't think I've ever seen her in a bad situation that turned it good. And she always just carried herself, you know, very dignified, you know, could dress up and, you know, stop the room, and at the same time she'd put on her sneakers and run up and down you just like one of the boys. So, you know what I mean? Always be missed and never forgot.
We had a lot of great conversations together, and we spent a lot of time talking. I really got to know her. She was very humble. She was a decent person with a huge heart, and we will always miss her.
My name is Stephanie. I also met Simone at Kaplan, and we became fast friends. We did family vacations and dinners and basketball tournaments. I watched them all play. She was an amazing person, huge heart. And like you said, anytime you saw her, it was like no time passed. So definitely gonna miss her. And sending all my love to her family and the kids.
My name is Aaron, and I met Sim through my wife, Stephanie. And just like she said, became fast friends. Very humble person. Anytime I hear her name, I automatically see a smile. Like, automatically pops into my head, because I don't think I ever saw her without a smile. Couldn't understand how somebody so loving could like Kobe, but again, like everybody else's theme, we all bonded over basketball and this great conversation, and truthfully will be one of the biggest misses in this world.
She was the first one that accepted me for who I was. Didn't ask any questions. Just accepted me for everything, and I would call her. And then I would teach her a couple things of girly stuff, nails, waxing, hair style. And you are gonna be really missed, Simone. And I love you.
Hi, I'm Shani. I met Sim through my brother Sequoy going to college, and she just kind of took me in as her little sister, introduced me to her little sister so I can have a parring partner, as like she liked to say. She was a sweet, genuine soul, and she'll truly be missed.
She was such a positive person, and no matter if you ask her, how's your day? She was always positive and always had something good to say. And she briefly joined me in a fitness group as she was trying to, you know, get healthy and get fit. And she was a great motivation to our team. And we're truly going to miss her.
From the very moment I met Sim and the crew from Nova University, it was such a family togetherness that everyone in that crew called me mommy. Sim, more than anything else, no matter where she goes or wherever we meet, she'd be running over to give me a hug. The last time I saw her with her whole family was going to her brother's graduation. She was so excited.
When we went to play basketball the first time, you know, she's like, don't play me soft, you know. I'm like, what? And like, she started talking smack and stuff on the court, and, you know, I'm like, what is going on, you know? And ever since then, you know, she's just a really warm person. She's like, you hardly meet people in the world today, and that's really good, and the world is so evil. And Simone is one of those people that always just push love, and it's just so real. And she would, like, if she had her both her legs and somebody lost both theirs, she would cut off hers and give it to that person. That's just the type of person she was. And, you know, the bigger thing behind this for me is just, you know, reminding everybody that life is so short and to always stay together, because that was one thing that she always preached, is family and love, you know. So she's greatly missed, and she touched me in a very deep way in terms of family and just being real, and she's gonna be deeply missed.
Simone, thank you so much, you know, for gracing our lives with your presence. You have definitely left a dent on the universe for all of us, and you know, to all the family, we love you so much, and just know that you know, you guys are all in our prayers, and just letting Simone know that, you know, we love her and the kids.
We pray, Lord God, that her life would not be in vain, but she would have an impact and an influence upon every person who have known her. That a part of her lives on in those who have known her. And that her legacy would live on in us.
I'll always be inspired by her. I'm gonna always love her. I'm gonna always remember her beautiful smile. And like Ken said, she could, you know, she could dress up in a gown and be in place, and she could hang out with the guys and play basketball or football and still be in place. So she was a unicorn. She could cook, clean, drive, anything. She was a unicorn, business savvy. So I'll take all those lessons. One of the last conversations I had with her, we talked about me running business ideas by her, because she was so good at it. I told her my idea. She said it's an amazing idea, and we're supposed to call each other, you know, every week and talk. So that won't happen physically, but I'll always remember her words and her smile. And like I said, I choose to remember her for who she is and not how she was taken from us. So that gives me, that just makes me smile every time I think about her. So yeah, cheers to our friend.
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Won't you come see about me? I'll be alone dancing, you know it, baby. Tell me your troubles and doubts, giving everything inside and out. me.